Welcome back to the Hillbilly RV Channel. Today, I'm going to be changing the end on a 30 amp shore cord. Here's our end. Now this is an RV style end, which means it's more of a rubberized plastic. So that if you drop it, which everybody's going to drop the shore cord in, it won't break. Because you can buy an end similar to this at big box stores, and but it's made out of some super brittle plastic, and this is not. So do yourself a favor, get you one that's really made for an RV, it'll last a lot longer, and you'll be a lot happier with it. Hey, if you're new to my channel, which a lot of you are, my subscriptions are just through the roof here lately. I really appreciate that to everybody that's subscribing. So if you are new, my name is Kenny. I am a hillbilly, and I work on RVs. Please don't forget to give my videos a thumbs up and share them with your friends. We can always use more subscribers. Be sure and check out the links below. There's email address if you'll email me. There's PO box if you want to send me something. There's an Amazon link. There's a link to my Amazon store. A lot of useful parts. Matter of fact, I'll try and find this, put that in my store. And the reason we're changing this one is because the end kind of blowed off that one right here. This lady had somebody doing some wiring on his coach, and they had a short when he went to plug it in. It blowed the end off that, and it's pretty corroded. So, once they get like that, it's time to change them, because it's just gonna keep getting hot and melting and corroding, and that's just no good for anybody. So let's go ahead and get started here. Just go ahead and open this end. There's the instructions. Just throw those away first. No, don't do that. I was kidding. Don't throw the instructions away. These things are pretty self-explanatory, but if we have to, we can refer to the instructions. This one here, we're going to need number 2 Phillips and number 1 Phillips screwdrivers. Yours may vary. That's what we need on this one. Hopefully these screws are captured, which means you can't lose the screws, because I'm working in the grass here. You drop a screw in the grass, it's gone forever, right? And yes, those screws were captured. Captured screws. So we're just gonna cut this old end off. Our handy dandy strippers. Just like that. Probably couldn't see because I was down out of the frame, but yeah, I lopped the end off. So now we can kind of hold our wire up in here and see that we're gonna need to strip some of this insulation off. Let's try and figure out how much. Probably about right there. I'll hold my thumb there. For this, I'll use my pocket knife and try my best not to cause damage to my digits. I don't think I've bled yet today, but yet is the key word. Chances are I'll bleed sometime today. Now a typical RV shore cord is going to have a lot of nylon strands of just strengthening material in here. So just trim those off. Get them out of your way. Drop it on the ground so you have to bend over and pick it up. Just like that. Now we're going to use our strippers to strip this insulation back on these wires, probably about, half inch or so. Maybe just a tad bit more. All right, this particular end has a sleeve that goes over the entire shore cord and then clamps in that end so that hopefully you won't pull the wires out. So we're just going to run that sleeve on there like so. Now these terminals will slip out of this end, and it may make it a little bit easier on you to at least slip them out partway like that. Let's get the screw that the wire goes under loose. Green is for ground. Silver is for white. Green is ground. Silver is white wire. And the black screw is the black wire. They color code it for you to make it easy on you. And let's see if we can get that wire stuck under that screw. Let's wind her up a little bit tighter. Shake the washer out to the end of the head of the screw. Need to loosen that screw up just a tad bit more. Wind this up again. Shake the washer out to the head of the screw. All right, now we're getting somewhere. Now let's just take and tighten that screw up on that wire. Sorry, it's hard to keep this in frame. Much more comfortable for me to put it down a little bit, but then y'all can't see. Of course, y'all can't see anyway, but we're gonna snug that up really good. I'm gonna slide that terminal in. Now we're gonna do the white one next. Loosen that screw up. You can watch on the back, loosen that screw up as much as you possibly can. Oh, you know what? On this one, the washers actually have two flat sides that's supposed to go down in the down in that terminal. So yeah, unlike me, you'll want to watch that. This is a really nice end. I've used this end the same end a couple times, and well, that washer just does not want to stay where it's supposed to stay. Story of my life. Nothing wants to cooperate. Everybody wants to give me a hard. Everything wants to give me a hard time. Need another hand is what I need. All right, let's see if it stays this time. You don't want to. It really don't want to. But it's going to, because I'm going to make it. Yeah. See? Told you it would cooperate. All right. Now, once again, let's start with go back to the white wire. Where was that just now? Before we so rudely interrupted. Before I realized that washer was not exactly where it needed to be. All right. Let's get the white wire under the screw. All right, what you don't want to do is you don't want to have any strands of wire sticking out under the screw. You want to get them all in there. See how I didn't? So I'm going to redo that. And the only way we can do that is just the shore winder wire up nice and tight and get it under the screw without losing any strands, which is sometimes easier said than done. I put my knife in my pocket with it open. Good thing that blade's not really sharp. All right. Okay. Now I'm happy with that. Let's see if we can get it tightened up now without the washer turning. I want so bad to put that screwdriver in my mouth, but I know where that screwdriver's been. Of course, I know where about all my tools have been. And none of them you really want to stick in your mouth. Let's just keep rotating that screw and see if that washer will straighten up. It almost did. Those washers having those two flat spots is actually just a little bit annoying. All right, let's see what happens now. There we go. Well, almost. Let's see if I can show y'all that here in just a second. Show you those flat spots. Yeah, ideally, if you had another hand, you could take and push that knife down beside that washer and keep that thing straight. All right, I bet I got it this time. I bet you. Oh yeah. Yep. Perfect enough. See if this thing will focus here. See those flat spots? Can you see those flat spots on that washer? Now that one's not exactly straight, but it's still down inside the terminal, groove on the terminal. So that's all we can ask for. Now let's do the black one. I need a table or help or more hands or something. I don't need more pockets because I lose everything in my pockets. My memory card filled up. So where were we? Oh, I got the black wire wound up nice and tight. Now let's get it behind the screw. It's really hard to show y'all some of this stuff. Cause I'd have to be behind it in order for y'all to see. And that just doesn't really work very well. Cause I kinda gotta see what I'm doing. I gotta see if that screw will back out of there anymore. Nope, there's where it was the end. Okay. Yeah, the last wire's probably always gonna be the toughest wire. There we go. Just because, yeah, you're dealing with those other wires also, that they're already attached. Figure out where I put my, oh, there's where I put my knife. At least I closed it up that time. There we go. Got it going our way now. So just go back, make sure everything's nice and snug. Then we're gonna turn this around, place that grommet down in the plug, And I think we will slide this back on this cord just a wee little bit. The green wire is kind of tight. There we are. Okay, so just put that down the groove where it belongs. Well, I'm gonna have to take that other strap, screw out of that strap, and then we'll put that strap over, and yeah, carry on from there. Seems like all these bolts are captured, which means they won't completely fall out on you. Okay, let's see if we can get screws started back in that strap now. Ooh, them screws are not gonna be overly long. Got one of them. Phew, that's gonna be tight. I might have to go get a pair of pliers to kind of squeeze that with. Let me see. Maybe I can get that screw started. Oh, it started. So we'll just snug that up real good. Like I say, this is what keeps the cord from pulling out of your plug. So these have to be nice and snug. Like that. There we go. Yeah, that's what it'll look like inside. I'm gonna just gonna push that green one back, that ground one out. Just make sure. Yeah, it's tight. Okay, just looked funny. All right, so. So there we go. All we do is put the back on. So just put the back on it. Like such. This one here just happens to have three screws that hold the plug itself back together. And that's their number one Phillips screws. There you have it. There is replacing the end on your 30 amp shore cord on your RV. As always, thanks for watching. I want to mention again that I really do appreciate all the new subscribers because there have been a ton here lately. So thank you very much for coming to my channel, subscribing. And hey, I'm going to go up the road and fix another one. And y'all have a fantastic day.